Welcome to a presentation on the derivatives of exponential and logarithmic functions when the base is not equal to e. I've already made a video showing how to find derivatives when the base is equal to e. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at our derivative rules. The derivative of the function a to the power of x is equal to natural log a times a to the x. If we have a composite function, notice we'll have a to the u times u prime instead of just a to the x. The derivative of the function log base a of x is equal to 1 over natural log a times x. If we have the function log base a of u, applying the chain rule, we would have 1 over the product of natural log a and u times u prime, and the u prime would end up in the numerator. Let's take a quick look at the proofs of these two derivative formulas. In order to derive the derivative of a to the power of x, we rewrite this as e to the power of natural log a to the power of x using our property of logarithms. And what this allows us to do is find the derivative of this using our derivative formula for e to the u, which is e to the u times u prime. So applying this derivative formula gives us this, and then simplifying, we end up with a to the power of x times natural log a, which is our derivative formula. For the function log base a of x, we apply the change of base formula to our function, and then we find the derivative of this using our formula for the derivative of natural log x. Natural log a is not affected because we're taking the derivative with respect to x, so we obtain 1 over natural log a times 1 over x, which simplifies to our derivative formula. Let's go ahead and apply these. I've typed in our derivative formulas over here on the right in red to help us. So to find this derivative, we should identify the value of a, which would be 5, the base. Our u would be equal to the exponent, x to the third power minus 4. And of course, if we have a u, we need u prime, which would be 3x squared. So our derivative would be natural log 5 times a to the u, which is 5 to the power of x cubed minus 4, times u prime, which we said was 3x squared. Now, when we're finding the derivatives of exponentials and logarithmic functions, we are going to have to play around with the algebra to make it match either the computer or the back of the book. Most often, they'll write the constants first, so we'll have 3 natural log 5 times x squared times the exponential. Okay, let's try a logarithmic function. Again, we're going to keep the same pattern. We're going to identify the key components and then apply the derivative formula. So here our value of a is equal to 3, u would be 2x squared minus 5x, therefore u prime would be, 4x minus 5. So the derivative of g would be equal to 1 over natural log a, or natural log 3, times u, which is 2x squared minus 5x, times u prime, which is 4x minus 5. Simplifying this, we would have 4x minus 5 in the numerator. Now there is a common factor of x here, but it doesn't simplify with the numerator, so I'll leave it as is. On number 3, we have a product of two functions. Our first function we'll call f, and the second function we'll call g. So we are going to have to apply the product rule as well as the exponential and logarithmic derivatives. Now to save some time, I've already wrote out the product rule. I haven't found the derivatives, but I set it up for us. Let's go ahead and find our derivatives. The derivative of log base 9 of x would be 1 over natural log 9 times x. Now natural log 9 can be written in a different form, but we'll come back to that. Plus log base 9 of x times the derivative of 8 to the power of x, which would be natural log 8 times 8 to the power of x. Now, the first thing I notice is both of these have a common factor of 8 to the power of x, so let's go ahead and factor that out. Now, let's take a closer look at natural log 9 and natural log 8. Natural log 9 can be written as natural log 3 squared, and then applying the power property, we could write this as 2 natural log 3. Natural log 8 can be written as natural log 2 cubed, which is equal to 3 natural log 2. So I'll rewrite this one more time using the simplified logarithms. Let's take a look at another. So this function is a quotient of two functions, so we are going to have to apply the quotient rule here it is in red. You may want to pause to verify it, but I've already set it up again to save some time. Let's go ahead and find our derivatives and then simplify. So the derivative of 2 to the power of x is going to be natural log 2, 2 to the x. And the derivative of 3x minus 1 would just be 3. So now the question becomes, how are we going to simplify? I see that both of these have a common factor of 2 to the power of x. So let's go ahead and factor that out. So if I factor 2 to the power of x out, I'm going to go ahead and distribute this natural log 2. And if I factor 2 to the power of x out here, I'm left with minus 3. And I think I'll leave it in this form. Let's go ahead and take a look at an application. An office machine is purchased for $4,600. Under certain assumptions, its salvage value, V, in dollars, is depreciated according to a method called double declining balance by basically 85% each year and is given by this function, where T is the time in years. And we want to address three questions. Let's go ahead and get started on this. The first question, when we evaluate V of 2 and then interpret, well, this is not a calculus question. We just want to evaluate this function when t is equal to 2. I've already done this to save time, and the value is $3,325.50. So we can conclude the salvage value of the office machine after 2 years is $3,325.50. Part B, we're asked to find the derivative of this function. Here's our derivative formula on the right. So V prime of t will be equal to 4,600 times the derivative of 0.85 raised to the power of t. So we have an A value of 0.85, and our x is equal to t. So we would have natural log 0.85 times 0.85 to the power of t. Now part C asks us to evaluate the derivative when t is equal to 3 and then interpret. So here's our derivative function from the previous screen. We need to sub in a value of 3 for t. Again, for the sake of time, I've already done this. Comes out to -$459 and approximately 11 cents. Now remember, this is a rate of change because it's the derivative. So it's the change in dollars with respects to time. So this is per year. So we can conclude the value of the office machine is decreasing at a rate of $459.11 per year after 3 years. We know it's decreasing because the derivative is negative, and this is only true right at when t is equal to 3. As soon as t changes, the rate of decrease will also change. I hope that helps explain how to find the derivatives of exponentials and logarithmic functions. Thank you for watching.